Hello, today's topic is stick diagram. So before going to the stick diagram, let us discuss about some points. So the first point I've written here is, we have seen the MOS circuits are formed on four basic layers. So recall our fabrication process topic. So when you see the MOS circuits, there is having a four basic layers in it. So four basic layers will be there in MOS fabrication process. So the first one is N diffusion, second one is P diffusion, third one is polysilicon, and fourth one is metal. Okay, all those are isolated from one another by a thin silicon dioxide material. Am I right? So, in MOS circuits fabrication process, we have four basic layers which we studied. One is N diffusion, second one is P diffusion, polysilicon, metal. All those are isolated with each other by a silicon dioxide material, which is nothing but an insulating one. And also, we must find a way of capturing this type of topology. So, whatever that we fabricated process, that should be represented. So it requires some topology. So that's the reason we must find a way of capturing the topology and layer information of the actual circuit in silicon, so that we can set up some simple diagrams which will convey the layer information as well as topology. So the conveying the layer information and topology is nothing but our stick diagrams. Right? So I repeat about this slide. We studied about the four basic layers in our MOS fabrication. One is N diffusion process, second P diffusion process, polysilicon, metal process, implantation process. All those we have studied. Okay, so let us discuss about the four basic layers. Basic four layers. One is N diffusion, P diffusion, polysilicon, and metal. All those are isolated with each other by an insulating material, which is a silicon dioxide SiO2. And next, we need to show these basic layers, so under the topology form. So there is a way of capturing the topology as well as layer information in silicon, so that it makes a very simple diagrams which will convey the layer information as well as topology information. So that conveying process is considered as a strict diagrams. So for these N diffusion, P diffusion, polysilicon and metals, I need to show some simple diagrams that will convey the layer information and topology to the real life, and that conveying process is considered as strict diagram. So I can define these strict diagrams is, a strict diagrams may be used to convey the layer information through the use of color codes. So conveying the layer information, nothing but layers, MOS, four basic layers we studied, N diffusion, P diffusion, polysilicon and metal. So conveying the layer information, conveying the that basic layer informations with the use of color codes, with the use of some color codes, is considered as this stick diagram. So in case of NMOS design, so let us take, I am taking one example. I am considering a NMOS design. Under that NMOS design, it is having a N diffusion. So N diffusion should be displayed with a green color or indicated with green. For polysilicon, we have to consider with red. Whenever there is metal, we have to indicate with blue. If there is any implantation for a depletion type of MOSFET, go with yellow, and black for the contact areas. So N diffusion for green. That's why I showed this green for N diffusion ward in green format, red for polysilicon, that's why I showed in red color, blue for metal, that's why I showed in blue, simply yellow for implantation, that's why I showed in yellow color for this part, yellow for implant, and black for contact areas. So black is there for total this point. So green for N diffusion, is displayed in green color, red for polysilicon, blue for metal, and yellow for implantation. So do remember this color codes, then it can be easy to convey our layer information. And these stick diagrams are used for capturing the topography and layer information using simple diagrams. So all the diagrams are simple, no need to worry. And these stick diagrams also acts as an interface between symbolic circuit as well as actual layout. Next, so this is our stick diagram representation, right? So this is N diffusion that should be represented with green color, and the mask layout will be this one. A crossbars, these are considered as crossbars. This lines is there now. All these lines are crossbars that has to move from left to right. That is moving from left to right. All these cross lines should be moving from left to right. I am drawing from left to right with green color. Then it is considered as end diffusion. I repeat, in going to the stick encoding or mask layout encoding, for end diffusion, I should be assigned this with a green color. Okay, that's why green is taken here. And in going to the mask layout encoding, it is having a bar with some cross lines which is varying from left to right. So all those left to right cross lines is there in this bar, left to right cross bars. So left to right, then we can consider it as end diffusion. So in going to the polysilicon means red color. If you see here, it is from right to left. It is from the crossbars are from left to right. Here, this is from left to right. This is from left to right. This is from right to left. So see here, this is from right to left of crossbars, cross lines. So for polysilicon, take a red color in which this bar. This bar line that has a cross lines from right to left. Next, for metal, blue color is considered. So blue has to be used for metal connection, and in that bar, a straight blue lines. For contact cuts, black, we can represent like this dot or a simple square box with filled with black color. So for over glass, color is not applicable. So stick encoding is not there for over glass. So the color for the over glass is gray color, and that is represented with a square box. Next, in going to the implantation process, where we will see this implantation process. Since our MOSFETs are of two types, one is PMOS and second one is NMOS. I repeat, MOSFETs are of two types, PMOS and NMOS. Under the NMOS, it is divided into two types. One is enhancement mode, second one is depletion mode. And MOSFET are of two types, PMOS and NMOS. And this NMOS is further divided into two types. One is enhancement mode, second one is the depletion mode. So under the depletion mode, there will be an implantation between source to drain. That implantation is represented with a yellow box. So this is one. Next, if there is any buried contact. So if there is buried contact is there, then we represent with this dot or with a square box, followed by an X mark. Next, N-type enhancement mode transistor. This is red and this is green. I repeat, listen carefully here. I repeat, this is polysilicon red. Polysilicon means red. And this is green, means N-diffusion. When a polysilicon crosses this diffusion, green color, when a polysilicon crosses this n diffusion, it is considered as n type enhancement mode transistor, right? When a polysilicon red color crosses this green color bar, when red crosses this green color bar, red means polysilicon crosses this n diffusion, it is considered as n type enhancement mode transistor. And the following mask layout representation looks like this. Or otherwise you can go through this symbol. So it looks very complicated, so that's why I prefer only this type of stick diagram. So in going to the n-type enhancement mode transistor, so if I want to draw a n-type enhancement mode transistor, I will just follow this step. The step is the polysilicon red color. When polysilicon crosses the n diffusion, polysilicon means red is crossing the n diffusion, it is considered as n-type enhancement mode transistor. In going to the depletion type, same, polysilicon crosses the n diffusion, n-type depletion transistor, polysilicon is red, is crossing the n diffusion green color with an implantation. As I said now, before that, the MOSFETs are of two types, P-MOSFET and N-MOSFET. N-MOSFET is further divided into two types. One is enhancement mode, second one is depletion mode. In depletion mode, there is an implantation. So, in enhancement mode means polysilicon crosses the diffusion. Polysilicon is red, diffusion is green. Same thing, polysilicon red is crossing the green N-diffusion with an implantation is considered as depletion MOSFET. This is an implantation which is represented with yellow color. Right, next slide. These are the stick type encodings. So green with n diffusion, which we discussed in our previous slide, similarly red, and next blue for red for polysilicon, blue for metal, black for contact cuts, gray for over gloss. So same thing, no need to worry. Okay, next p diffusions. So up to now we studied about n diffusion here. So this is n diffusion. N diffusion means green. Okay, polysilicon means red, metal means blue, contact cut means black, glass means gray, implantation means yellow. Now discuss about, this is all about n diffusion. Now we discuss about p diffusion. P diffusion means represent with yellow color, yellow stick. And the mask layout will be like this. And the mask layout is like this. So, but here, see here, under the NMOS, N diffusion, in this bar, it is varying from left to right. Right, I am right. Under the N diffusion with green color, this bar has a cross lines from left to right. Cross lines from left to right with the small spacings, but in going to the PMOS, same, from left to right with large spacings. With large spacings is PMOS, with small spacings is NMOS. I repeat, same, N diffusion mask layout and P diffusion mask layout are similar with each other, but here yellow and this is green. Here the in this bar the lines, the cross lines is having small space, that is varying from left to right. Here also left to right only, with here this is small spacing, but here these are large spacing over here, right? And please, P plus mask is represented with yellow like this. Metal 2 is represented with these lines, horizontal lines, where in case of metal 1 vertical lines are drawn, in case of metal 2 it is horizontal lines, in case of this one vertical lines, in case of this horizontal lines. So same, contact means dot, and next demarcation line. So where we studied this one demarcation line, we studied in CMOS, where this demarcation line will separate the PMOS as well as NMOS. In CMOS, it has both the PMOS as well as NMOS circuits existed in it. In CMOS, it has both PMOS as well as NMOS existed in it. I repeat, in CMOS, it has both PMOS and NMOS. But these PMOS and NMOS should be separated by one line, and that line is a demarcation line. That should be represented with a dotted brown color line. Dotted brown color line. And VDD and VSS should be represented with a cross X mark. And the corresponding mask layout should be displayed like this. Same thing, N-type enhancement mode transistor, which we discussed here. So same, polysilicon crosses the diffusion. This is enhancement mode. Similarly, P-type enhancement mode means, P-type means when this polysilicon crosses the P diffusion. This is P diffusion. This is yellow line. When this polysilicon crosses this P diffusion, a transistor is going to exist. That is P transistor. When this polysilicon means red color, when this polysilicon crosses the N diffusion, when this polysilicon crosses this N diffusion, it is considered as N MOSFET, N type MOSFET enhancement mode. If there is implantation, then it is depletion mode. When this polysilicon red color crosses the P diffusion, it is considered as P MOS. When this polysilicon red color crosses the P diffusion, which is represented with yellow stick, when this polysilicon crosses this P diffusion yellow stick, it is considered as P type enhancement mode. And the corresponding mask layout looks like this. See both of them. So this is polysilicon crossing the N diffusion. Same, polysilicon crossing the P diffusion. Wherever there is P diffusion, I said that in mask layouts, it should be represented with a yellow surface over the mask. This is our yellow surface over the mask. Next, so there are some rules in the stick diagram. The first one is, when two or more sticks are of same type, crosses or touch each other, that represents the electrical contact. So if you see here, wherever, if you see in this video, I am representing all with the color formats also. No need to worry about that. Okay, here, rule one, we have to follow these rules while drawing the stick diagram. Okay, in rule number one, when two or more sticks of same type, So see, this is blue color and this is also blue color of same type. This is red and this is also red, same type. So when two or more sticks of same type crosses each other, so both are crossing with each other, that represents electric contact. So this is electric contact and this is also electric contact, since both are of same type. Otherwise, it is not a electrical contact. So if you see here, this is red color, blue color. This is blue and this is some another color. So these whatever I am showing with the cursor, mouse cursor, okay, all those are different types. So these are non-electrical contacts, and these same type cross or touch each other. So same type means blue, red. So this is a electrical contact and this is a non-electrical contact. And rule number two, When a polysilicon crosses the diffusion, it represents a transistor. So this is, as I said, that polysilicon should be represented with red. So this is red, is crossing the diffusion green. So this is green is N diffusion. So the same thing, when this polysilicon crosses this N diffusion, it is considered as a transistor. I repeat, when a polysilicon red color crosses this green bar or green color, which is diffusion, when a polysilicon crosses the diffusion, it represents a transistor. Right? Next, rule number three. In going to the rule number three, in CMOS, a demarcation is drawn to avoid the touching of P diffusion and N diffusion. So the upper part is P diffusion and the lower one is N diffusion. So here what is happening, this polysilicon is touching the N diffusion. So it shows this a NMOS transistor, and this upper one is a PMOS transistor. So between this PMOS and NMOS, between this PMOS as well as NMOS, there will be a demarcation line which is represented with brown color. Okay, demarcation line should be in brown color. So in going to the CMOS, a demarcation line is there to avoid touching between P diffusion as well as N diffusion. What, how can you say this is an N diffusion? Means here the red color, which is polysilicon, is crossing the N diffusion. So that's why it is a NMOS transistor and this is a PMOS transistor. Both are separated by a demarcation line that should be represented with a brown color. Next, in going to the depletion MOSFET, there will be an implantation box or square box is drawn all around the transistors. See here, this green color is N diffusion and this red color is polysilicon. Green is, the green color is there, whatever this here, whatever there here is green color. So this green color is N diffusion and this red is polysilicon. So see here, this polysilicon is crossing the green color, N diffusion. Poly is crossing the diffusion. Then it makes a transistor. Within this transistor, there is a square box with yellow color. Then we can say that this is implantation. It is implantation. This yellow box is implantation. This yellow box is implantation. Which transistor is having implantation? A depletion MOSFET is having implantation. So this is the representation of depletion N MOSFET. So in going to the contact cuts, that should be assigned with a dot mark or black, or we can represent with X mark. No need to worry, right? So these are the rules. Rule one is, when two wires of same type touches each other, so two colors of same type, then we can say this electrical contact. Otherwise it is non-electrical contact. And when a polysilicon red color crosses the N diffusion, represents transistor. Rule number three, demarcation line brown color separates the P diffusion, PMOS transistor as well as NMOS transistor. Rule number four is implantation. Implantation should be there for a depletion MOSFET. Since it is a polysilicon crossing the N diffusion with a implantation seen in yellow color, that shows a depletion N MOSFET. And next one is contact cuts with black color. This is this one is contact, and this is also a contact cut, right? Next, basic NMOS inverter stick diagram. So up to now we have discussed the representation of our layer information with some color codes. So before going to draw the NMOS stick diagram, we have to recollect our color representations. Once again, I am repeating, whenever there is N diffusion, that should be represented with green. When there is polysilicon with red, metal means blue color, black means contact cut, gray means glass, implantation means yellow. When a polysilicon crosses the N diffusion, when a red color crosses the green color, when a polysilicon crosses the N diffusion, it is NMOS transistor. And next one is, when the polysilicon red color crosses the yellow, which is P diffusion, when a polysilicon crosses the yellow P diffusion, it shows a P type of enhancement mode transistor. And in going to the buried contact, it should be represented with in case of VDD or VSS, it should be represented with X mark. So these are the some points should be remembered. So all these things, these two slides are very, very important and plays a key role in drawing the stick diagrams. Okay, right. And next, let us go for our NMOS inverter circuit. This is our NMOS inverter circuit, which we have studied in our previous video. So this is VDD. See here, this one is a metal. Supply rails, VDD and VSS or ground. Both are this one and this one. Both are supply rails. Supply rails means metals. So metal means it should be represented with blue. So that's the reason I taken a blue here and blue at this point. And there is a contact cut here and here. That should be represented with black contact cut. See here, this is enhancement mode NMOS transistor and this is a depletion mode with VGS is equal to 0. I repeat here, this is an enhancement mode transistor and this is a depletion mode transistor with VGS is equal to 0. Gate and source should be short circuited. Once again, I am repeating, it is an NMOS enhancement mode transistor, it is a depletion mode transistor. So under this depletion mode, gate and source are short circuited, VGS is equal to 0. So in going to the enhancement mode, so go to this enhancement mode. So this is our enhancement mode. The poly red color should cross the poly red color should cross the green color end diffusion. This poly should cross the end diffusion green color. So the same thing, enhancement mode should be represented here. So this is green, this is green end diffusion and red is polysilicon. So this polysilicon is crossing this end diffusion and this 1:1 ratio is there now. This will act as NMOS enhancement mode transistor. This circuit is similar to this one. If you see here also carefully, and this red color is crossing the green, means N-type enhancement mode transistor. N-type red color polysilicon crossing the end diffusion. So same thing, red color poly is crossing the end diffusion. And next, in going to the depletion mode, so see here, this is our depletion mode. The depletion mode is also same thing. N color, red color polysilicon should cross the end diffusion green with implantation. So the same thing I written here. This is polysilicon. This is polysilicon red color crosses the green color. So it forms a transistor. Since it is a depletion MOSFET, so depletion MOSFET will has an implantation that should be represented with yellow color implantation, yellow color. So that's why I am representing this with a yellow color. Here VGS is equal to 0. Gate and source should be short circuited. That's why this gate is connected to this source with a polysilicon only. So this is the representation of NMOS inverter stick diagram. Once again, I am repeating. Listen carefully. So here the supply rails VDD and VSS are ground. Both are metals. So metal means considered a blue color. So that's why blue color is considered. Here some contact cut is there, which is showed here dotted dot. So contact cuts is represented with black color. Contact cut means black color. So that's why black is represented here. Next, this is NMOS and this is NMOS enhancement mode and this is depletion mode. In enhancement mode, poly should cross the end diffusion. End diffusion is represented here with green color. Poly should cross the end diffusion is enhancement mode. See here, this is poly red color polysilicon is crossing the green color, which is end diffusion. This is N-type enhancement mode transistor. The same thing I did here. Similarly, if there is implantation for this polysilicon crossing the end diffusion, it is depletion MOSFET. See here, this polysilicon crossing the end diffusion with an implantation yellow color, that is represented here. Yellow color is represented. This is depletion MOSFET. But I am going to short circuit this gate and source. So here gate and source are short circuited. That's why I shorted with the polysilicon itself. So this is all about NMOS inverter. Next, in going to the CMOS inverter. CMOS is a combination of PMOS as well as NMOS. If you see here, so this is our PMOS and this is our NMOS. Combination of PMOS as well as NMOS. PMOS as well as NMOS. So first, same thing like here, NMOS similarly. So this is metal, two supply rails, VDD and VSS are two supply rails. Both are metals. metal means blue color. So blue color here, and this is also a blue color. So two blue colors. So both metal and this is also metal. I repeat, here it is having two supply rails, VDD and VSS. Both are metals, and that should be represented with a blue color. That should be represented with a blue color, since metal is represented with blue. So that's the reason I am representing this with blue color, with contact cuts of black. And these two are separated by a demarcation line. These two, PMOS and NMOS. CMOS is a combination of PMOS and NMOS. These two are separated by a depletion. These two are separated by a demarcation line. So demarcation line, where we studied here, the demarcation line should be represented with brown color. So that's why a brown color is used here. So in going to the PMOS, PMOS has P diffusion and polysilicon should cross it. So I'm going to the P diffusion. So this is P diffusion. In P diffusion, what should I do here? In going to the PMOS, the polysilicon should cross. This is polysilicon, nothing but gate is crossing the P diffusion, represented with brown color here, but we can use yellow. But yellow intensity contrast is very less, so that's the reason I taken a brown color here. No need to worry. This is P diffusion. The polysilicon is crossing this diffusion. This is poly. Red color is poly. Is crossing this P diffusion. It forms a PMOS transistor. I repeat, for VDD and VSS are metals. Also, I represented with blue color, with contact cuts black. So with black. So I need to draw a PMOS circuit first. This is P and this is N. So CMOS is combination of PMOS and NMOS, PMOS as well as NMOS. So first I need to draw the PMOS here. So for PMOS, polysilicon should cross the P diffusion. So this is P diffusion, brown color. Actually, it should be represented with yellow, but I represented here with brown, since light intensity of that yellow looks very damaging. So that's the reason I taken a brown color here. So this is a P diffusion, and this polysilicon is crossing this P diffusion. So it forms a P transistor. Similarly, here for N, green, N diffusion is green. When the polysilicon crosses this green, when polysilicon, this is red color, polysilicon crosses the N diffusion. So which we seen here, this is green color, polysilicon crossing this green color, it forms a N type transistor. So same thing. So green color is N diffusion. A polysilicon is crossing this N diffusion. So this forms a NMOS. And here this P diffusion, polysilicon is crossing this P diffusion, it forms a P transistor. So this is the resultant CMOS inverter stick diagram. So otherwise we can you can draw this like this also. You can draw like this also, or otherwise you can go through this process, or otherwise you can go through this process. So let us go for one of the realization Boolean function, which is F is equal to A plus B whole complement. So this is our A plus B whole complement. This is the circuit. So in the previous section only we studied about the realization of logic gates using CMOS. Here A plus B, plus means plus operation means summation. Summation means OR gate. So this is whole complement. So this total thing is NOR gate. So A plus B. So plus is summation component is there. So therefore NMOS should be in parallel. NMOS should be in parallel, and PMOS should be in series. This is A into B whole complement. So A into B whole complement. So A into B, product term is there. Product term means NMOS should be in series and PMOS should be in parallel. So the same thing I did here. This is NMOS is connected in series and PMOS is connected in parallel. This function is A into B whole complement. F is equal to A into B whole complement. A into B whole complement means A and B should be connected in series for NMOS, and A and B should be connected in parallel for PMOS. So between these two common point, I am taking output. So we need to draw the circuit for that. So this is the resultant circuit stick diagram for the function F is equal to A into B whole complement. So for the supply rails, I take in blue color. This is whatever this color is there now. This is P diffusion. When this poly crosses this P diffusion, this dotted lines is there now. This is P diffusion. Here poly is crossing. Here also poly is crossing the P diffusion. So it forms a P transistor B. Here the poly is crossing this P diffusion. So that's why here A input is taken. A PMOS circuit is formed. When the transistor action takes place means when the polysilicon crosses the diffusion. So if you see here this color, actually this should be represented with yellow, but as I said that yellow is dominating the contrast, screen contrast as well as brightness. So that's the reason I am going to take any one of the colors. So this is a P diffusion. So this is a P diffusion. Poly is crossing this. Here poly crossing. So a transistor existed here. A transistor existed here. This transistor works as an input for A, and this is also works for the input B. And in going to the N diffusion, green color. So green color. Polysilicon crossing. Polysilicon crossing. So two transistor existed here. NMOS transistors. One is acting as input A. Another is acting as input B. So this is the resultant diagram for the function F is equal to A into B whole comp, right? And next we're going to the mask layouts. So mask layouts or mask design is a representation of logic circuits in terms of planar geometric shapes that implies in terms of patterns. So in here in stick diagrams we are representing, in going to the stick diagrams we are representing with the help of colors only. See here, we are representing with only the colors. In going to the mask layouts, we are representing with some patterns. So see here, this bar, some cross lines from left to right with green color is N diffusion. Red color in a bar with left to, from right to left is considered as red. So some patterns is there. This is all about mask layouts. So the same thing I am explaining here. Mask layout or mask design. Mask layout or mask design is a representation of logic circuit in terms of some planar geometric shapes, means in terms of patterns with color codes. Okay, see here. So this is our CMOS inverter, the corresponding stick diagram and the corresponding mask layout that we will discuss in our next video. No need to worry. This is a color hatching process. This is the basic CMOS inverter, stick diagram for this CMOS inverter. This is a mask layout, and the resultant mask layout will be shown like this, CMOS inverter, right? See here, I repeat, CMOS inverter. This is CMOS stick diagram, CMOS mask layout, resultant mask layout. So see here, two supply rails is there, VDD, VSS. So one metal, metal with blue, contact cut, black. Poly crossing the P diffusion, so P transistor. Poly crossing the N diffusion, N transistor. So output is a metal one, so blue color output. Same thing, same this blue color, blue. Red poly crossing the poly. This is poly is crossing the P diffusion, so P transistor formed here. This poly is crossing the N diffusion, so this is NMOS. Poly crossing the P diffusion, PMOS. So resultant, this is metal, this is also metal. So blue color, output red color, and contact cuts is replaced square box with black color. So the resultant circuit, this is the resultant circuit. So okay, for reference, go through the textbook Basic VLSI Design by Douglas A. Pucknell and Kamran Ishragya. So thank you for it. In the next class, we will discuss about the mask layouts and some of the design rules for that mask layouts also. Thank you.